everyone. Hi, this is Devleena. I'm Pragati here. And today we've come up with a topic which is not very usual. Usually, psychology says that stick to the positive, stick to the do's.
Absolutely, yeah. And never ever go negative. You know, never ever talk about no, don't. Like, you know, try to restrict the usage of these words.
But today, what we will discuss is how we can implement a couple of don'ts in our lives to better ourselves and to better our relationships. Usually, Pragati, we often see that we can use don'ts for another. Don't do this, don't say that.
Don't talk loudly.
Yes, but when it comes to ourselves, we hardly have a reality check about these don'ts.
And you know, I feel that we feel so comfortable saying don't to others because we never ever use don'ts on ourselves. You know, it's like a projection that we use. I would rather not see it in myself, but I would rather give some kind of gyan to somebody else.
True. So let's see, we've come up with 10 pointers again today about the don'ts that we can implement in our lives.
And the first one is, don't quit.
It's very easy to quit. You and I both know it. It's extremely easy to quit when the going gets tough. We all feel that tendency to quit.
And you know what happens a lot of times, I've put in effort and let's say nobody has appreciated it. If I'm a student, the teacher does not give me the marks which I'm expecting. So I feel, what's the point of studying so hard? So I quit.
In relationships, when things are not working, we often feel that I have put in so much. Since it's not working, let me quit.
And at work, if I'm not appreciated for my work or somebody else gets credit for what I'm doing, I just want to quit or not put in my best.
Yes, that's the reason why so many people resign within a few months of joining some work.
And the attrition rate is so high.
Yeah, because this whole thing of it's not working, so I better quit.
So the first don't for yourself is don't quit. And the second one is don't overthink.
I think most of the blunders in our life happen because of this overthinking business. We are constantly overthinking, we are constantly overanalyzing, we are constantly just going a little overboard with our thinking.
You know, here I give an analogy here of driving a car. Mm-hmm. See, when you drive a car, if you are in good practice, you know how to navigate from the second to the third to the fourth and then the fifth. If you aren't, like if you see a novice driver, immediately when he starts the car, he goes to the fifth gear or he is struggling on the first one. So what really happens is, this is what happens with our thinking. We don't practice engaging in meaningful thinking, or we always think thinking is bad for me. So the result of it, what happens is, we either overthink things or we don't think at all. We are mindless about things.
So overthinking does not lead us to any constructive solution of our situation. What leads to constructive solution is probably thinking in the right way at the right time about the right things.
Yes. So once we do that, we won't overthink things. We would just think which is enough and which will make us mindful about things. Third one, don't lie.
We all have a tendency to lie. Yes, it would be complete denial, it would be complete dishonesty if we say that we don't lie. Some people say, I'm a very honest person. But honesty comes with a certain percentage.
I'll give you a very small example how we lie. Let's say I'm a very honest person, but my best friend asks me, how's my dress looking? I may feel that it's not very flattering, but most of the time I would say, oh, the color is so nice. It's looking nice only because I know she's put in a lot of effort. So whether I like it or not, I'm lying.
Exactly. So there are hundreds of mindless lies that we keep telling ourselves and telling another. If we stop telling these lies to ourselves, I think somewhere they will seep in and we'll stop using these mindless, harmless lies on another.
And you know why we are saying that don't lie? Because everybody can make out if you are lying. You know, there's something in our body language, there's something in the way we talk which signals to the other person that all is not okay, something is missing. And the fourth one, don't waste time.
We all waste so much time on mindless things. Only if we realize, all of us realize this at some point or the other, this human life is so precious. And we have such limited time on earth. So if only we realize that and we stop wasting time.
See, See, the reason why in school, you know, we are put in a routine is actually to make us realize that there are multiple subjects we can study at one point, even though we know nothing about it. Also, there's time for sports, there's for time for watching TV, there's time to chat in with your parents. So this is something which is ingrained into each school-going child. But as we grow older, we procrastinate.
Yeah, we come off on our own when we are no more under the influence of some authority figure. That's when we tend to go a little haywire with our time management. We start doing a lot of things which are not needed, and we start neglecting things which are actually going to have a significant impact in our lives.
So the result of it is, I'm always more stressed out because I'm strapped for time. So the fifth one is that we are always afraid. So the fifth one is, do not be afraid.
Yes, actually, in the face of any kind of fear, if you ask yourself, what am I afraid of? What am I going to lose?
You know, we always live in the past or the future. In the past, we've had some experiences where we've lost things. So we always use that as a reference point, or we think of the future. Oh God, I'm going to lose this.
I'm going to give a personal example here, something that's applicable to you and me.
Okay.
See, we'd been thinking of doing these videos for a very long time.
Yes.
But why didn't we do it? Because we were afraid that we wouldn't be able to make sense, or something wouldn't be right.
Yes.
But the day we overcame it, and the day we started it, we realized maybe we're not absolutely perfect. But what we have to offer may be valid.
And this brings us to the next point. Don't think small. You know, if you have a message, if you have something to talk about, just go all out and work at it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Thinking small has a very deep-rooted base on our self-esteem.
Yes.
If you think of it, why is it that we are not able to think big? Because we think that we are not good.
Yes.
We are not good enough.
Or maybe it's out of our comfort zone. I'll give you a very simple example as in ergonomics. What are we told? Straighten your shoulders. You know, widen them a lot. Because the moment we constrict ourselves, we are self-harming. Whether we like it or we don't like it. So even for our posture, if we can't really restrict ourselves and think smaller, make ourselves smaller than we are, then why do we do it with our thinking? And that brings us to the next point, which is?
Don't procrastinate.
Oh God, we all love to say, I'll do it tomorrow, what's the hurry?
I'll do it later.
Yeah.
And that later mostly becomes never.
Yes. And we are always left with regret. I wish I had done it when the time was right.
So we all face procrastination. We all want to procrastinate things. We all push it for a later time because it's something that happens out of our comfort zone.
Yes.
We are so attuned to the fact that we need to be in our comfort zone. We need to make ourselves feel comfortable first. Yes, we need to make ourselves feel comfortable, but at the same time, we need to challenge ourselves out of our comfort zone.
Yes.
All achievements happen there.
And you know, if we get into escape and avoidance just to remain comfortable, then we are not being the best that we can be. So I need to just do things when they need to be done. How I figure it out is something which I can definitely do it if I put my mind to it.
The next point, point number 8, is don't underestimate yourself.
Often, you know, remember little children, when they write compositions, they never think that whether they are Shakespeare or not. You always watch a class 1 child, the teacher says write 10 sentences on a cat. Very happily the child writes and presents it so proudly to the teacher. Because the child knows that whatever I have done it to the best of my ability.
You know, once this takes me back to an example of a workshop that I was conducting, and it was for a group of professionals, and I'd asked them to draw their dream house.
Okay.
And everybody started with a certain amount of hesitation that I'm not a good painter, I can't draw, I can't sketch to save my life. So there were some who reluctantly picked up the pen pencils and color pencils and all of that. There were some who enthusiastically dived into the worksheet to realize that then when they finished the picture, I asked them, do you like what you've drawn? There were almost 80 people, out of which I think 95% said no.
Yeah.
Things are not really nice.
It's disproportionate, you know.
Exactly.
The lines are a little skewed. Nothing is seeming very nice, or it's a very basic house.
But the same thing, if you take it to a school level where you are doing it with a bunch of 5-year-olds, none of them will say that.
They very happily grab the pencil and they start drawing. They don't care that they haven't had enough drawing lessons. They're just happy that the joy of holding a pencil and someone wants to see their work. They don't underestimate themselves, and that's why they feel that creativity, you know. So when we don't underestimate ourselves, we are at our creative best.
Absolutely. Yes. So the 9th point is, don't take in other people's negativity.
You know, when we started off, there were people who said, your hair looks good, you need to look here in the camera. The whole thing is, everything is nice, but. So these buts of people, we really just do not need to soak it in.
See, the thing is, if we had soaked in the buts of other people, I think... I think what would have happened is, we would have stopped making them. Making these videos, we would have stopped voicing what we feel or our opinion or maybe the valuable stuff that we want to talk about to the world.
And you know, a lot of times we need to realize that people mean well. But the whole thing is, how much of it is helping me grow as an individual?
Sometimes, like it happens to us, we do it ourselves. Other people are also human and they tend to go a little negative.
Yes.
Your loved ones, your family, friends, your well-wishers.
Yes.
But then you have to understand how much of it is feedback and how much of it is another person's personal negativity which is seeping into you.
Yes.
If that is happening, you need to constantly tell yourself that it is another person's game. It is another person's issues. I cannot let that hamper my ways of being.
And you know, it's like when you're on the roads, there are people who shout slogans. You hear them, but you don't soak it in. They may have a just cause, and there may be a lot of scope for growth for you. But the whole thing is, what is it doing to you? Is it making you feel negative about your endeavors? Then you definitely don't need to soak it in.
The last one, the 10th point is, don't say yes to everything.
Oh my God, so many times, you know, we say yes and then we realize that it's an extra shoe around our neck. We can't cope up with the pressure.
Yeah, saying no becomes very difficult, especially if you are a woman. I am sorry, I'm being a little gender biased here, as you may think, but it is a very genetically programmed thing in women. Saying no directly impacts our self-esteem.
So many times I've seen, like women, you know, let's say they have a class to go for or some personal chore that they need to do. And immediately the child comes and says, Mom, help me with my homework, I didn't finish it last week. What does a mother do? Leaves everything. Instead of telling the child, look, you had the full week to finish your homework, you should have asked me at some other time. Now I need to just finish my exercise and come back or do my groceries or whatever. What is it that the woman says? Okay, fine. I'll do my thing later on. Do we or do we not do it?
Yeah, when there's a domestic crisis, the woman is the first one to stop all her other activities and to stay indoors.
Yes. And you know, saying yes to everything even penalizes men in their well-being. Because a lot of men I've seen say yes to their friends, to their work colleagues, and then they realize they've taken on more than they can chew. The good thing about men is, at least they're genetically not programmed to say yes to everything. So they sometimes manage things a lot better than they would have otherwise.
So these are the 10 don'ts to be followed in your own personal life. When you gradually implement them, you will see how much better your life becomes, how much of a first-class citizen you start feeling in your own life, and hope it works for you.
Absolutely. Because you know, ultimately, why these don'ts are going to work for any of us is because our internal climate is very important. A lot of times we second-guess ourselves, we don't put our best foot forward, or we feel we can't achieve things. So with these don'ts, hopefully you will achieve whatever you wish to.
Okay, with this we sign off our today's video with the message again, it works only if you work at it.
Okay, bye-bye.
See you.